a Pilates studio called Free Spirit Pilates. So yes, we have a lot of Pilates. Pilates on the mats, on the reformers, and on all of the other Pilates machines available to me. But we also have bar training and yoga classes. Today, we're gonna do a yoga routine. Yes, we're gonna do a nice, flowing, energizing yoga workout. It's a great workout for you to do at all points of the day. You can do it in the morning, you can do it in the afternoon. We're gonna check in with the core, awaken the legs, arms, do some spinal flexion, and of course, tap into the breath. If at any point through the workout, you feel like you need to change your position to feel more ease through movement, please do so. This is what's really great about yoga. You shouldn't force yourself into any position. This should be a really great mindful experience. Before we begin, if you need to make yourself comfortable, have a sip of water, drink up your coffee or tea, please do so. It's very important to set the tone of your day with the way you set the tone for your workouts. So let's get to it. So we begin sitting at the end of the mat. You can sit on your knees. If you feel more comfortable in a cross-legged position, please choose your own version here. Yes, so just start with your hands to your knees and flex forward. Change your chest. Keep on roll up your spine. Hands to the thighs. And just reach up behind your ears towards the sky. Open up your fingers and loop your shoulders down. And just sit reaching out of both sides of the body. And find your breath here, so deepen into it. Inhale in through the nose. And exhale out through the mouth, maybe with a closed mouth. And then just sit here, stretching both sides of your body. Soften your eyelids. And try to open up your heart. Let it shine towards the sky. Then find the intentions for your workout. This should be a good experience, but try to visualize the intentions for this workout today. Stay, reach your arms down, and let's do a little spine twist. If you're on your knees like me, then twist and go to your thigh. If you're cross-legged, go to your knee. Then stretch and open up the sides. And deepen into the breath, stay. Shoulders come down and lift the heart up towards the sky. And then just turn to the other side and twist. So try to lift yourself up and feel the opposition from the crown of your head to your tailbone. Come to the center. Interlace your fingers to the back and open your chest. And if it feels right for your body, maybe come to your knees. Shining up towards the sky, opening your shoulders. And sit back. And come to all fours. Wrists under your shoulders and knees under your hips. And stay here for a cat-cow. So stretch out through the tailbone, open up your chest, inhale. And exhale, curl up the spine, look towards the navel. And just be Feel the nice movement through the spine. Exhale, curve up. Maybe stay here. Just rock a little back and forth. Try to figure out where the stiffness is in your back. Breathe into it. Come to a tabletop position and come wag the tail. Just push your fingers down, push yourself away from your ears. Side to side. Come to the center, jump your toes under, lift your knees, and come to your downward dog position. Stop pedaling your feet, massaging your feet. You need to get a little flexibility in the ankles. Open up the hips. Come to the center. And lift up to the tippy toes. Press your heart through your arms, let it shine to the floor. Open up the tailbone towards the sky. And then just anchor down your feet towards the floor. Feel the stretch of the hammies. And then just walk towards your hands. Forward fold. Just feel the neck. If there's any kinks, try to stretch it out. Everything feels heavy here. Then lift to a flat back. Maybe fingers to the floor, to your chin, so your thigh. Find your own version here. Straighten out your back. To your forward fold. Bend your knees a little bit and then roll them. Bring your fingers or trunking your thighs all the way up. Arms to the side, lift overhead. Mountain pose. Push your fingers together, press. Thumbs to your sternum, tusk. Inhale here. And exhale. Just walk your feet together and maybe make a little space between your heels. Lift and lengthen up through the spine. And lower your arms. Bend a little bit on your knees. So you make a little bouncy beam on your knees and then open up your arms. Towards the sky and forward fold up and over. Open your chest down to the floor. And again, flat back up. See if you can fit a little teacup at the back of your head. And forward fold. Bend your knees and step back in your lunge position. Fingers come to the mat and try if you can open up the chest. This is where we tend to curl over with our shoulders. Bring your shoulders to the back and try to open up your chest. Keep breathing here. Bring fingers to the floor and then step back to your plank. Position. Press your hands away from the floor. You can maybe feel a little heel to seat connection as you flex back and then drop back and forth. Come to your toes, elbows to your waist and bend down to chaturanga and come to your upward dog.
baby cobra. Come to your floor, tuck your toes in, lift yourself back to the downward dog position. Start paddling your feet. Keep breathing and deepening into your breath. And walk to the front, forward fold, bend your knees and roll all the way up. Arms to the side up, and thumbs to your sternum, lift your heart up, and bend it down and open it again, and forward. Left back up. Forward fold, bend your knees, and step back to your lunge, open up your heart to the other side. So feel your hips is going down, but you're lifting up and over your knees, so you're not hanging over your front knee. Step back to your plank, lift and lengthen up, maybe rock a little back and forth again, come to the front, elbows are in, bend down halfway maybe, and come to your cobra, maybe a little higher this time, oh great, and let your feet in. And come back to your downward dog position. Out. And step in. Your hands forward fold. Into front back position. Beautiful. Take your knees and roll up. So reach for the sky, fingertips kiss, and close to your heart. And lift up and up. And open up. Forward fold. Flat back up. And down. Let's try to just hop back to the plank for a little vinyasa pose. And jump. And bend down through the elbows. And come to your cobra, upward dog. To the mat, let your feet. And come back to the downward dog. This time, let's come to a three-legged dog. Lift your right leg up. And try to turn your toe, your big toe, internal, so your hips come down. Stay here and breathe. And lift, bend your leg up and under, knee to nose, and stay here. Lift your abs in and up. Just two breaths. And place your foot on the floor, knee to the floor, and come up. And try here to square your hips. Don't sink into it. Try to think about a position. So lift up from the crown of your head, track your heel back, track your thigh bone back. And then unleash your fingers. Lift and open up the chest. And if it feels okay, maybe move your foot a little to the front and deepen into the stretch without sinking into it. Stay, breathe into it. And fingers come to your foot. Flex your feet, lift your heel up, and then come back to your plank position. Let your ass flow. Bend halfway down and lift up. Up and down. Down and come back to your downward facing dog. Lift your left foot up, three legged dog. Sink your hip down. And then lift and bend to your nose, stay. Lift yourself up and over the floor. Keep breathing into the deepening, opening your back, lifting your hips, and step right through, knee to the floor, and lift up. Interlace your fingers and keep lengthening up, looping your shoulders down. The heart is shining to the sky. And if it feels good, deepen into the stretch and keep thinking about the opposition in the body, lifting up while you're deepening in, opening the hip. Breathe into the hip. Your knee up, come to your plank position, and then as the flow, bend down, lift up. And down, and come to your downward facing dog. And walk in. Forward fold. Let your neck go. Bend your knees a little bit and then roll up. Drive back first. Forward fold. And then roll up. Arms come to the side. And down to your heart. Arms to the side. Let's continue. And fold forward. Flat back up. And down. Jump to the plank. And there's the flow. Bend down. Lift up, maybe. Put a little more energy into it. And down. Lift back to downward facing dog. Lift your right leg up. And bend it. Open up the hip. And then feel like you're stepping it up to your bike, so you have to lift your knee over to your elbow. Stay, two breaths. Step in between your hands and lift up to your high lunge. Arms to the sky. And then grab your right arm, hand, grab your wrist and then open up, deepen into the stretch. And stretch the side over. Try to stay open in the chest. Let go of the head, arms come to the side, and then the lift over your knee and try to press yourself away from the earth. Hands to your foot, step back into your plank, and yes, the flow, bend down. Lift up. fingers and your shoulders. Then we come to your elbow, up and up. Stay here and breathe. Between your fingers and then lift up to your high lunge. Look to the front. Arms come up. Grab your right wrist and then stretch to the side. Stay. Opening up your chest. Look to the front. Arms to the side, press them a little bit back, and then lift the right foot over your leg. Hands to your foot, and then step back to your plank, and use the floor, bend down, lift up. Back to your extended child's pose position. Open up your knees a little bit. And just find ease, rest. Bend your elbows, fingers over your head. So try to make a little sharp thin over your head. And track your elbows to the front. Feel the stretching in your shoulders, in your back. And find ease in your breath. And try to turn back. What was your intentions for this workout? Did you fulfill it? And how does your body feel right now? And then just roll up. So we're done. I hope you built up some heat. Please leave a little comment or questions if you have any. And then turn back. Try to find some balance between all the workouts on my channel. If you haven't subscribed yet, I would really love to if you would. So see you next time.